Ya tomé Kawaii.
Here today. I'm sorry, it's my first assignment and most of my crew is out with food poisoning. I told them not to order sushi on a Monday. Everyone knows that's the leftovers from the weekend. Wow, I'm rambling. Hi, I'm Kelly Porter. I'm Reggie's producer. Oh my goodness. Okay, if you don't mind, I am going to sit you down and I'm gonna mic you up. How does that sound? Okay, great. We're going to throw you right here. And, you know, I've never done this before. I'm wearing a lot of hats today. But not makeup and hair. You know why? Because Dax, sup Dax, Dax and I are vegan. And we didn't catch the same plague that the rest of the crew caught. Okay, so you know what? I think I'm going to need an audio level from you. So, yeah, just...
Cat, dog, penguin.
That nigga's on Italian.
Check, check, 1, 2, 1, 2.
Hello, hello.
Oh, hell no.
Cat, dog, penguin.
Sounds good. Okay, everything looks good. Reggie, it's all yours.
Hey. Oh man, it's great to have you back with All Star.
Yeah, it's good to be back and to see your familiar face. You look great.
Oh, come on, man. Look at you. You the one that look good. So listen, basically, today is going to be pretty straightforward. You've seen the show before. Okay, well, I'm just going to ask you some questions about your life and career. It'll be fun reminiscing. And don't worry, okay? I got your agent's threatening texts and... The kid glove stays on today. Okay. Whoa, whoa. I see you still got those all-pro reflexes.
Yeah. Ironically enough, that's how it all started for me.
You know, if memory serves, you didn't start out playing football back then.
That's right. It's my first day here as a transfer student. Football kind of just found me.
All right, here we go.
Now for the Beast de Renaissance. Your helmet. Got those fancy words from this French girl I met recently.
Why tripping? Why ain't no helmet?
Let's see what you can do.
I don't know, coach. I haven't played since Pop Warner.
Okay, football's just like music, kid.
Sure, I'm a trip.
Once you learn how to play it, it never leaves your soul. Besides, if you're as half as good as you are in hockey, we're in great shape. Hey, Tommy, give him a ball, would you?
We've already got a QB, coach. A darn good one based on the colleges that have already made me offers.
And a modest one, apparently. Look, we still don't have any depth behind you. If we want to compete for state, it's always best to be prepared.
All right, suit yourself. We got plenty of room on the bench anyway.
Let's see.
Come on, say yellow.
Most basic, it's in practice. Right.
Ready, go!
Oh, I'm tripping. Do I not know how to do a touch pass?
Go.
Okay, I guess not.
Okay, right? Ready, ready.
Oh, now I throw a touchback.
The edges, I definitely see some potential. What do you say we smooth out those edges at practice?
Sounds good, coach.
Good, good practice.
Welcome to the team.
Hey, thanks, man.
All right, man, listen. I'm gonna be real with you. This ain't gym class, okay? This is my team. And as long as you understand that, we'll be fine. You got it?
Need to hook up my mic while I'm in here.
Find yourself a box, keep it clean.
Alright, here we go.
Seat's taken.
Look, man, I ain't playing with you, bruh. Don't sit beside me, all right?
Yo, get out of here, bro.
Hey, find yourself another spot.
Captain of the team in the corner away from everyone. Shouldn't you be in the middle of the locker room, morale and all?
Well, I'm just over here for some peace and quiet. I'd like to get my head clear before a game. But I can't really do that if guys like you keep bothering me. No, I'm sorry, man. I'm sorry. It's just this whole recruitment thing, it's really stressing me out.
Thought you had a ton of offers.
I did, but they can disappear as quickly as they come in. Plus, if I'm not on my game at all times, I can pretty much kiss it all goodbye. I mean, no full ride to college and no shot at the NFL.
NFL? That's a bit lofty, isn't it?
Maybe, but I got a lot of people counting on me, so it's the NFL or bust.
Well, if you're as good as advertised, that shouldn't be a problem.
Yeah. You'll get a chance to see up close on Friday night.
Who's that?
That's Reggie Brown. He's in charge of the school paper and the social media account. He's a pretty good kid, just, you know, a little annoying. Great. And here he comes. What's up, Reggie?
Tommy Matthews. The man, the myth, the legend.
What's up, Reggie?
Oh, maybe an exclusive for the paper?
You know, winning me over with flattery will absolutely work every time. Okay, I got an exclusive for you. You ready? Okay, so get this. You're really gonna love this. Okay, so today I was in the cafeteria. And you know how I usually have a chocolate shake at lunch, right? Okay, so today, this is crazy. I had a vanilla shake. That's crazy, right? Vanilla.
Yeah, well, tell me, man. You gotta give me something I can use here. Anything, man. Well, how about a quote?
Okay, Reggie, here's a quote. Tommy Matthews scores 4 touchdowns and leads his team to another victory. How about that?
Okay. Yeah, I'm sure I can make that work. It's better than nothing, I suppose.
Hey, if you really want a quote, I can help you out.
Who are you, exactly?
Yeah, I'm the new backup QB.
Backup QB. Yeah, I'm good. No, thanks.
Damn.
On second thought, I need something to report on, and it might be worthwhile for the fans to learn the new face of the team.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Ask me anything.
Okay. First question. Which quarterback style would you say you emulate the most?
Well, it's been a while since I played competitively, but back in the day, my game was closest to...
Definitely Tom Brady.
Tom Brady. Read the defense at the line, then get the ball out quick for long, sustained drives.
All right. Solid answer. So, when out on the field, how would you describe your personality in the huddle?
Well, no matter what sport you're playing, the most important thing you can do is be ready when your number's called. So, whatever coach asks me to do, I'm gonna do it.
Finally! That's something I can report on. Thanks, QB2. I see you out there Friday night.
I don't even want to be a quarterback. Right.
Tommy. You all right, man?
Yeah, I'm fine. I just have this bug that's going around.
You don't look fine. You look sluggish. It's like you're not playing with any heart out there.
Don't you dare talk to me about my heart. I've put everything I have into this. This game is my life.
If you have so much heart, prove it. Because you're not showing any out there. Oh, hey, easy.
From the pass out.
Easy, man. I ain't mean to upset you.
You're right.
About what?
What we out here looking like, mean machine?
About my lack of heart.
Mean machine looking
Look,
like.
I didn't mean anything by it.
No, it's my heart, man. I was born with a congenital heart defect.
I forgot. He got a what?
It's what does that mean
heart
exactly?
What is that?
That means that my heart doesn't push blood through my body properly.
Oh, damn. He finna die.
Tommy, I'm sorry. I had no idea.
I had a surgery when I was 9 to repair it, but my doctor's saying I need another one.
Tommy, you need to get help immediately.
Listen, if word gets out about this, that's the end of my football career. Do you understand? Please, you can't tell anyone about this.
This is serious. You can't afford to wait any longer.
It's just fatigue at this point. I'll be fine. Okay, I just need to get through this season. Plus, I owe it to these guys to help them win a state championship.
I ain't no snitch.
Fine. But I don't feel right agreeing to this. If it gets any worse, then I'm gonna have to tell Coach.
What, and let you take over? I don't think so. I'll be fine.
All right, boys, bring it in.
Tell him to sit down.
Is that a word?
Well, it's hard to celebrate homecoming when you're being shut out by your crosstown rivals. Tommy Matthews is just not playing
time.
Like himself tonight, and that is the
it's
major storyline as we continue.
I'm sitting on the bench. And we getting cooked.
There's going to be another play for you tonight.
What?
We need to take off your helmet and take a bench.
He's going to die.
Coach, what do you mean? You're pulling me? After everything I've given to this team?
I'm doing what's best for you and for the team. Please, take a seat.
Let me
Coach, I don't know what he told you, but I'm fine, Coach. I've got scouts here watching me tonight. You can't do this.
He moves shorter than Marco anyway.
Hey. Look, I need you to
He's gonna
easy.
Pass out.
We'll talk about this
he
later.
He gonna die like that dude for 2K.
Listen.
Yeah, he gonna die like Jake.
What'd you say, man?
Let the trainers do their job. I know you're worried, but you got 52 other guys out there. I need you to focus. They are all counting on you.
52 guys? No sweat, coach. I can do it.
Good, because we're going to need you to ball out. That's not asking too much, of course.
Oh, no, I got this.
Was it the play calling?
I mean, I've had 2 whole weeks to digest everything. I'll be fine. What could go wrong?
Great. Well, with your raw athleticism, you got this.
Hope you're right.
Whoa, you forgetting something? The helmet.
Oh, not a helmet combo.
The most important part.
Oh, man, this dude.
Come on, you got this.
Like, I'm a rookie. Yeah. Who the fuck I think
you're right, coach. I got this.
Yeah? Yeah, you got this.
He still doesn't got this.
Boy, I'm finna get him. He said I don't got this.
One more quarter to go in this always emotion-filled homecoming rivalry. Kevin Connors and our entire broadcast team bringing you the live stream action courtesy of EA Sports.
Is this man?
And he's taken down at the 33. So I'm not sure what to make of this, but Tommy Matthews was just benched for a backup who joined the team only a couple of weeks ago. And get this, his teammates nicknamed him QB2 because they thought he'd never see the field, but he caught it.
Oh,
it's a touchdown.
QB2
throws for a score on his first play of the game. Are you kidding me?
Who is this kid?
So they trim the lead by one more point. The score now 13-7. So an unexpected drive by an unknown backup we call QB2 leads the way to this kick.
Huh?
Fielded in the end zone. And he'll kneel down for the touchback.
That didn't help. I just thought it was.
The Bearcats take over on offense.
Oh,
and there's Coach Summers yelling some instructions to his QB from the sideline. And boy, that closed up quickly as he only gets this up to about the 27-yard line. All right, so following the short game, here's second down.
Oh, wait a minute. I'm going to fuck the game up with this.
From the gun, it's Carpenter. And he's not able to come down with it. Third down on the way. Following that incompletion, it's 3rd and 8. Shotgun snap. Here's Carpenter.
Oh, I'm moving.
And they're unable to make the connection. So here comes 4th down. So following a drive that came and went, here's the punt after a 3 and out. And he
Bro,
sends
I could
it
have
away.
Seen this whole time and I ain't know it.
Washington fields it.
Oh, yeah, I'm going. I'm going.
And he's tackled at the 46-yard line. QB2 came off the bench to lead his team to a touchdown the last time out. Here's a chance now to prove it wasn't a fluke. Completes that throw on the crossing route.
And
he's down at the 13-yard line. A 33-yard gain. And these fans, they're going crazy. From the back of the eye, Hawk scans the field. First down, and here's the ground attack. And he's past the 10 to the 7.
Why do you see it so fast?
A pickup of 6 on the play. So it'll be 2nd and 4. They come out 5 wide, three to the right, looking to throw on 2nd down. Here's QB2. He's got it! Touchdown, Rangers! And this game is tied at 13. Can you believe it? And they'll take a narrow lead, just 1 point between the teams.
Damn.
The tally now, 14.
Oh, I can super zoom? Oh, man.
What? What?
Let me see.
What are you doing?
I Ice Speed just more good.
I'm finna get back on Face of the Franchise if you can do that.
Let me see. Yeah, I'm gonna play all offense. Skip that. Oh, they didn't score it on us? I'm finna just throw that bitch up. Sim?
Throwing to start the drive.
Throw that bitch.
Here's QB2.
I'm gonna throw this bitch up.
Deep with this throw.
Oh, yeah. Oh!
But they can't.
Oh, I'm retarded.
Took a shot on first down,
damn,
but couldn't
I'm retarded.
Finish it off. Still 10 yards to go after that incompletion on first.
People, I just did it.
Drops back and he'll throw it again.
Oh, yeah. Big screen.
Delivers on the screen.
Oh, yeah. Ooh.
Oh,
ooh,
a great
I feel like Nelly.
Series
ooh.
Of moves. And this will be spotted at the 48.
They might as well call me Nelly. They might as well call me Nelly.
And that's a first down and then some.
You better call,
from
you don't
the
have to call me Nelly.
To
no.
He's
oh, yeah.
He's going deep for
oh,
Patton.
Yeah. Ooh.
And that's caught in the end zone. Touchdown.
This nigga did
the
Johnson. He said, you can't see me. Oh. Oh. We about to lose. We finna lose. We about to move.
Throwing to start the drive. Here's QB2.
I'm throwing it up again.
Going deep now for Patton.
Ooh.
He pulls it in. And they pull hey. It.
Hey.
Touchdown,
hey.
Rangers.
Hey. Let me see. Hold on. Let me see if we're going to win. What will happen if I lose? Oh, we ain't lose.
And that will do it! A comeback to remember! So as our EA Sports live stream comes to an end, I'm Kevin Connors, signing off.
You watching it?
Yes, sir.
Just with one eye, with both of my eyes, all right? Keep doing good work, and I'll be in... Hey, Grant Simmons, recruiting analyst over at recruitstowatch.com. Heck of a game out there tonight, sir. Hey, you ever think about your future in football? Where you might want to commit to?
I want to be a quarterback.
Really.
I mean, I want to be a wide receiver.
I'm just kind of having fun out there.
Yeah, yeah, I see you out there having fun. Well, look here, when you're ready, give me a call, all right? I'd love to add you to our site.
Look, dude with the heart disease, man, as hell.
My man.
The man of the hour. You're the hottest scoop this year. Got a few moments for an exclusive?
Sorry, maybe some other time, Reg. I got a lot of prep for the playoffs.
I'll tell you what. If you give me the exclusive, I'll put together your senior highlight reel for recruiting next year.
Wow, you'd really do that?
Heck yeah. Man, I got a lot of tricks to get a lot of eyes on your tape, too. Yeah, I do that for all the guys that are pretty nice to me, which is the kicker and now you.
Sold. I need as much help as I can get with recruiting. All right. Let's get started.
Wow, great. Okay. Let me think. Oh, regarding your last game, what would you say is your biggest strength?
Oh.
My biggest
oh, wait
strength.
A minute. Hold on.
Just think of one of them. Any.
I felt like
damn,
I was able
even
to sense
looking.
The pressure.
Hold on.
And then get out of the pocket and get it to our backs before the pocket collapsed.
All right, well, if you're not going to play me, I quit.
With heart disease, mad as hell.
Well, Reg, I guess there's the exclusive.
Need a word in my office.
You hear me, little man? I said heart disease, mad than a mother. No reason.
You're under the
beach,
Welcome to our EA Sports live stream from AT&T Stadium, the home of the Texas High School Football State Championship, and the host of tonight's clash.
Speaking of talking through the mic, I need to get that mic on my own.
Joining you on this beautiful evening, I'm Kevin Connors.
Microsoft being lazy.
Well, I don't know what to say. Is
oh, hell no. I gotta play this whole game? This.
Game time in the state championship. Caught in the end zone.
I'm finna send this. Hold on.
As he drops to one knee.
I'm finna send this, big dog. Hold on. Let me see. Oh, yeah, there we go. Oh, we have the five?
The drive begins on the ground with
Hawk. Go.
Touch toward the right
Damn,
side.
Is this easy?
He's ahead of the pack. He's at the
is
40.
This easy?
The 30. 10. Woo!
Give me some.
Touchdown. Sammy Hawk, a show-stopping score from beyond midfield.
Bro, they must have this set on rookie or something. This must be on rookie.
They start the drive with Hawk, and he'll scoot his way forward for a solid game.
I can't believe that throwing these acts that hurt
social media, it can be a recipe for drama. And Clay Rainey stirred up some controversy this week
now.
When he predicted a championship win for his Brushhawks. He makes the grab.
I'll be mad if all you have to do is send somebody deep to this top square and they open. I'm ready for the NFL, no.
The drive begins on the ground with Hawk.
Oh. Damn.
And all it takes is one play to move the sticks. A great run there.
I play for Mean Machine.
So you're hitting me up on social media wanting to know exactly what Clay Rainey posted. And it was an invitation to his championship party tomorrow evening. Yes. Very bold, you know, and he's taken down at the 25-yard line.
Oh, this man hit a home run.
And that's what the fans came to see. Now another first and 10, and even more of a threat to score now. Off the play fake.
Oh, yeah. Ooh.
It's
oh, yeah.
Touchdown, Rangers.
Hey. Hey.
Right now.
Man, I'm not finna watch this. Hold on.
Back
I wonder
up
if anybody actually
want to
watch me play this, but this is kind of boring.
On first down. Grabs the snap. Let's one go deep for Patton. He's got it.
Ooh,
10. And he takes it into the end zone. Touchdown, Rangers.
That spin didn't even do nothing.
He's finally taken down. So the comments keep coming in now on my channel, and yes, I did see Sammy Hawk's reaction to the Clay Rainey party invite. For those who haven't, here's what Hawk said. You can delete the post, but screenshots live forever. Touchdown! Just two plays needed to find the end zone.
Bro, I'm finna send this. I don't wanna play this. It's 35. It's 42-3, bro.
And that will do it. The Rangers are state champions. Signing off now, I'm Kevin Connors as we give way to this euphoric scene.
Hold on.
I feel like Michael Jackson. Moonwalk through the
telepathy. Hold on.
Hey, LeBron. Second bottle. Hey.
Alright.
Right here is my favorite part. The spin move you do. Breaking that dude's ankles and the stiff arm, woo! Reminds me of my playing days, Samoan warrior style.
It's too bad you stepped out of bounds. You could have scored a touchdown.
Look, there goes heart disease.
There's no way you could have dodged. Tommy, how the heck have you been?
Hey, Tommy, how you feeling, man?
Good. Got a clean bill of health. I'm ready to get back out there.
Come on in, have a seat. Didn't think you'd be back.
Trust me, I tried transferring. Doesn't seem like any other schools want to accept a perceived health risk. But I've got a clearance from my doctor, coach. I'm ready to play.
Oh, you can have it.
What do you think?
I don't want it.
It's only right you take your spot back. I was just keeping it warm for you.
You know, the team seems to be doing just fine with you out there.
Damn.
Seeing that you're kind of thin at receiver, I was thinking that maybe I could help out by lining up outside.
Shoot, yeah. We'll work something out.
Like you said, coach, you gotta do what's right for the team.
It's the best news I've heard since my Aunt Lokalani's bore one best in show.
Damn.
I'll get the playbook. We're gonna start drawing some stuff up. Woo!
I'm trying to see the cutscenes.
I know I'm not your favorite person in the world right now.
You're not even in my top 7 billion.
That's fair. Just know I did what I did to protect you. Not to try and take everything that you worked for. And I can understand if you're angry with me, but I'm gonna do everything I can to make it right.
I'll tell you how you can make it right. The Midwest Prep Showcase, later this season against the Central Hawks.
What about it?
Well, they're the best team in the country, and it's a nationally televised game. That means every recruiter's gonna see it.
So what do you want from me?
Just want you to let me go out there and do my thing. And show the recruiters what I can do. It's my last chance at getting an offer.
Fine. But if it's not working out there, then I gotta get the other guys involved.
Trust me. You won't need to.
All right, let's see what's next.
One of the loudest venues in the NFL on Sundays looks to be no different on a Friday night. Damn. We've got a packed house for the Midwest Prep Showcase. Soon,
hey, them
two of the best high school football teams in the nation will collide here at Arrowhead Stadium when the Hawks take on the Rangers.
Wait, it's your...
Yeah, rapper, producer, entrepreneur, Snoop D-O-double-G. Please believe it, that's me. But hold up. Ain't you one half of the Heartbreak
Snoop
Boys?
Snoop in the game.
I'm a huge fan of
yours. Nah, man, I'm a fan of yours. Check this out. If the coach and half the stadium knew what I was about to say, they try to run me out of this town, man. But let me tell you this. I've been following y'all's story for quite some time. And I'm pulling for y'all tonight.
That's amazing. Thank you so much.
For sure, my brother. Now get out there and go do your thing.
Snoop, you know Tommy Matthews?
I wonder what that team play is doing once you throw
Tommy.
It up.
Hey, man, it's a pleasure to meet you, man. I'm such a fan, man.
Hey, likewise.
Love your hard work, your dedication, and how you just put the team and put everything on your back, man. That's beautiful, man. It takes a whole lot to do what you did.
bastard. Thanks, man.
Let me tell y'all something. Y'all better get out there and make it count, man. It's a whole lot of schools that's gonna be watching y'all tonight. And I got a feeling I'm gonna see y'all again. Good luck. Ball out.
Will do.
Thanks, Snoop.
For shizzle, Snoop.
This nigga said for shizzle.
We just met Snoop D-O-double-G.
I know. That was cool.
What? Let's go do this, man. La-di-da-di-da.
Oh, hell no. I'm playing offense. I play offense.
To the 22. So get this. Earlier today, I was speaking with Hawks coach Kevin Robbins and
consistent catches and running back.
He did not hold back about today's matchup. He proclaimed his D would be so good against QB2, they'd end up putting Tommy Matthews hauls it in the end zone. Touchdown!
Jesus.
Just
this nigga did the T-Pain. This man did the T-Pain. Never.
The drive begins on the ground with Hawk.
Woo!
Oh, everyone felt that one. He's out in front, and he's all the way home for a touchdown. Sammy Hawk, a show-stopping score.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Here's QB2. He makes the delivery. And he's out at the 49. A 26-yard gain and a big time play. From the shotgun now. Inside handoff.
That's face mask.
And he'll get this to the 45. It's time to switch sides as we conclude the opening quarter. And after a short break, we'll begin chapter two of the Midwest Prep Showcase. Back to pass on second down. He'll go deep for the end zone. And that is caught. Touchdown,
hey,
Rangers.
Hey. I never know the capabilities.
Start the drive with Hawk. And they're not able to stop him before he comes up with the first down. All these kids so thrilled when they found out this year's edition of the showcase would be played at the home of the Kansas City Chiefs, Arrowhead Stadium. This is now a premier event on the high school football calendar. He makes the catch. And he'll do it himself. Touchdown. Start the drive. Here's QB2. They set up the screen and that's complete.
Oh, come on.
At the 42. Apparently, the kids on the field weren't the only ones thrilled about this game being at Arrowhead. We've got an incredible turnout for one of the most hyped matchups of this season. Picks up a nice chunk of yards before he's brought down. A gain of 7 on the play. And now it's 2nd and 3. Hawks lined up behind QB2. Off play action. Going deep now for Fuller.
Oh!
Touchdown, Rangers! Benny Fuller!
That nigga named Benny. I'm sure y'all don't want to see this for Benny. Yeah, y'all don't want to see this.
And that will do it. The Rangers win the showcase. On behalf of everyone at EA Sports, I'm Kevin Connors, signing off.
I can't wait till I play the yard. I ain't gonna play it yet though.
This question is for both of you. What trait do you think would give you the edge at the next level?
Not yet.
I think my ability to quickly find the open receiver is what really sets me apart.
I mean, it must have been a little easier with me out there, right? When you snap the ball, you throw it to Tommy, rinse and repeat. But seriously, though, the past 2 years have really put things into perspective for me, and thanks to this guy, I'm just fortunate enough to have the opportunity to go to college and further my football career.
Well, okay, gang. I think that puts us in a great place to go to find out where these two are going. All right, gents, who wants to go first?
I want you to have the honors. It's the least I could do for all you've done for me.
Right. I'll go first. Clemson, Miami, Florida. Damn, that's a good question. I think I'm gonna go to USC.
Oh, wow.
Do something different.
Wow. So the decision is made. Tell us, when it came down to it, what led to this choice?
Well, there's been a lot of elite talent that have walked those halls, and I'd love to add my name to that story list. Plus, the opportunity to play for a legend like Coach Miller is too much of a draw. He's a guy that's had a ton of success with the school.
I don't know where he's gonna go.
I think there's a lot I can learn from him.
All right, Tommy. What you got for us?
Let's see. Who's it gonna be?
You didn't go on Michigan State? Oh, hell no.
Tommy,
oh,
question.
Hell no.
Well, isn't it obvious? I mean, Batman needs his Robin, and he can't break up this
Heart
dynamic.
He's up to something.
But in this case, I'm Batman and you're Robin. I never said I wouldn't try to win back my own position.
I knew that nigga was up to something. I don't even know that nigga real name. I call that nigga Heart Disease.
Details rolling in, everybody, on today's crazy news. Coach Miller is stepping down from his illustrious college coaching career, and in his place, the school is promoting hotshot defensive coordinator Red O'Brien. Now, Coach O'Brien has been all the rage for quite some time, sitting at the top of a ton of schools' shortlist for head coaching gigs, but it sure looks like he's just going to stay put and take over the entire program. But what I really want to know is what it's going to mean for everyone's favorite dynamic duo, the Heartbreak Kids.
Oh, you saw Michaels?
I know you've both been sitting patiently for the past 2 years, waiting for your shot, so I made a decision.
Mm-hmm.
Neither one of you will be starting.
What? I ain't
Come
gonna
on,
get
Coach,
mad.
Give us a shot.
I'm not even going to get mad. Damn. How many rings he got? Good lord.
How many of those do you guys have? Now, as I was saying, neither of you will be starting, but both of you will be playing.
And I ain't want to start anyway.
Sorry, but I'm not switching positions.
I'm not asking you to switch positions. You both get reps at QB. It's a defense first team now.
What?
So I don't need your heartbreak kids nonsense. All I need is for one of you to manage things and make sure the offense doesn't give the game away, because my defense certainly won't.
I'm not listening to somebody that smells like
Newport. You've seen what we did in high school.
I don't
care what the heartbreak kids did 2 years ago, son. I'm more concerned what you can do now in college and winning a lot more at ease. So I'm going to rotate you guys. I'm going to stick with the hot hand until I see what I can get out of one of you. Oh, yeah. You'll start the first half. Deal well enough, you'll stay in. If not, we'll see what Tommy's got.
Coach, you can't be serious.
That's some bullshit.
You two are competitors, right? Well, that's how you're going to have to approach this, as a competition.
I forgot USC got these Hulkamania uniforms.
Go on, get out of here.
No hint of fall here on this hot and humid Saturday afternoon. Hey. Students and alumni have made the early season pilgrimage to Hard Rock Stadium in Miami for the season opening kickoff classic on EA Sports. It's the home state Florida Gators taking on the Trojans from Southern Cal. College football is back here on EA Sports. The new season underway here in Miami.
I go.
Taking it about the one. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 33.
10-10 at their own 33-yard line.
The long lineage of quarterbacks for SC has led to him as he gets ready for his first collegiate snap. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away.
It is.
But it's caught inside the 20. And he's able to get this way down deep into enemy territory. A big play there on the first play of the game. 54 yards. The first down carry here for Charles. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up first and goal. From the two, here's first and goal. Trying to pound him with Washington. And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Trojans have taken the early lead.
Oh, I ain't got a flip. I ain't cool. Cool.
Start the drive with Washington.
Oh.
And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
No gain.
The stop for no gain brings up second and 10 from the 20.
20-yard line.
Back to throw here. Screen pass to Charles.
Oh.
And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of 3. You know, Charles, you and I get to call a lot of games at the next level, but walking into the stadium, there's just something about the college atmosphere, the bands, the pageantry. So nice for us to be able to get the assignment to... This is caught at the 20, and he will score. Touchdown,
spike
USC.
That moment.
What a special moment for him. To begin the drive. And down he goes,
break. No
but
tackle,
he takes
bro.
It up to the 40. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down. Here's first and 10 for the Trojans.
10-10 at the 40-yard line.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun.
What a move.
This complete to the tight end, Clay.
What a move.
And he will score. Touchdown, USC.
USC.
Boy, these guys are...
Yeah, we only have.
They begin the drive with Charles. And he'll get about three as he takes this up near the 25.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But
oh, yeah, he's pushing. I got
get a couple of first downs.
I got
run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath.
I got
settle down and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
This is caught inside the 15.
I got you.
And he will score. Touchdown, USC. I'll tell you what, a pretty special
performance.
First down, Charles, and he's across the 40, three extra yards to the 43. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
Why must I say Carson?
Brings up second and three.
Second and three.
Damn, I got so much time. I can throw that dude. Oh!
And oh, he sucks. Drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
When you look at the scoreboard, you'd think they'd be pretty comfortable right now with this lead, but these guys are absolutely not going to let up. They want to increase their lead, and they want to do it with a big play. Unable to connect in that attempt.
And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. They're able to convert with a gain of four.
First and 10 at the 47-yard line.
Ooh. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw.
Oh,
the attempt on the dive, and he has it. What a catch. 23 yards, the final tally. So first and 10 now from the 30.
30-yard line.
They'll run from the gun with Charles. They find some open field here. And touchdown.
I don't think anybody wants to see this. And I got good degrees. I just want to see the coach from anybody like me. But that beat hard though. Hey. Hey. Oh yeah, that Josh stock trending up. Yes, sir. Fuck with me. I know y'all wanna see no gameplay. Y'all know what the game gonna look like.
So things got off to a solid start. But after several weeks,
I'm gonna do
you
so
and Tommy
old.
Had rotated quite a bit. Reminiscent of Michigan when Tom Brady and Drew Henson split snaps. That had to be frustrating for you both.
Some huge wake up. To get to, and none more intriguing. What are these dishes doing at my feet?
Because it's time for you to start cleaning up your crap. These dishes have been lying in the sink for almost 2 weeks. I mean, look at this place. It's a disaster. You're leaving everything laying around. It's ridiculous.
Who crawled up your butt and died?
You.
That nigga said, who gross. Crawled up your butt and died?
Hey, get up, man. I want to watch some TV. You've been laying out here all morning.
What's got you two all riled up?
Just turn up the volume, would you?
The Heartbreak Kids have gone from sensational dynamics.
That's why he hurt.
A sudden two-headed monster, and boy, this
heart disease having motherfucker.
Hey, I thought I played pretty good out there.
This team still has not found its identity, and I know that Coach O'Brien claims that his two-quarterback system is matchup-based, but I gotta tell you, it sure looks like he still doesn't have a clue what's going on. As Coach Madden famously once said, if you've got two quarterbacks, you've got none. And right now, I gotta tell you, man, Coach O'Brien's indecisiveness with the most important position on the team is only gonna lead to problems on the field.
The answer is simple. Just stop me.
Thank you.
That would make the situation worse. I mean, the team plays better when I'm on the field. Everybody knows that.
If I could just get into a rhythm, I'd be fine. Last thing I need is to be worrying about you breathing down my neck if I make one mistake.
Well, you better believe it that I'll be there when you do.
Okay, I see what's going on here, guys.
I don't know What made you follow me here and try to win back your old position? I mean, you could have just kept the Heartbreak Kids going, or you could have went your own route on another team, but you decided to what? Come here and punish me? Is that it?
What are you talking about? You're the one who showed up and stole what was mine in the first place, okay? I'm supposed to be Batman, you're Robin.
You know what? I ain't even gonna argue with you.
But we're in this together.
I ain't gonna argue with dude.
No, we're not.
I'm not gonna argue with dude.
I'm just gonna leave.
You really gonna argue with him? Just insult him a little bit.
I don't know what his problem is.
You gotta go talk to him, man. Go clear the air.
He's the one with the problem.
I should have said that.
Look, if he wants to talk, he can come find me.
Look, I'm being nice.
That's what he said when you pick Lodge up.
Jumping fiddlesticks.
I ain't even trying to argue with dude. I'm Kawhi Leonard.
This is so boring. I want to skip.
Skip
like,
it.
Come on, bro. I can't.
Why?
You can't skip the second game.
I ain't got time to be arguing with niggas.
AT&T Stadium on this beautiful Saturday in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. The top travel destination this week for alumni of these two-story powerhouses. And the site of the of our college football playoff semifinal matchups. As we'll see the Clemson Tigers taking on the USC Trojans. For the right to play for a national championship next Monday night in Santa Clara, we are underway from Arlington in the national playoff semifinal. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone.
Y'all got to watch him play this.
The decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
Y'all got to watch him play this whole game.
Clemson now with a first and 10. They begin with Henry, and he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5. The ball carrier.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Here's a second and 5 now from the 25. And he stopped immediately there.
DeAndre Jewell, the ball. And I think you and I were both raised the same way in the game of football. You run to set up the pass, but I think we've discovered in this NFL, a lot of teams pass to set up the run. And that's what they've done throughout this game. They've aired it out, thrown it around the yard.
Oh, damn!
To the running game, and they find a way to be successful with it.
Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect.
Damn!
So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
21 yards. Well done on the return. Come the offense as they take over. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at the 39-yard line. Flush to his right. And Walker has it. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. A nice throw there, Coach O'Brien. When you look at this quarterback position, he's got two great options, but opting to go with a hot hand, leaving Tommy Matthews on the sideline to start this semifinal.
And throughout this season, they've got a little bit of what we would call the carousel approach of quarterback. But when they've made changes, Tommy Matthews has made the most of his time under center. But both of these quarterbacks are undefeated, and we know why. This defense has played so well throughout the season, and we know how loyal the
fans
are. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5.
Damn!
A big pickup of 38. First and goal from the 3. They'll let Charles try and get him in. They're able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop him right around the 1.
Bro, this nigga just climbed on the earth.
Good first step there defensively, but they're still knocking on the doorstep, so maybe another run here?
I think so.
And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. Taking it in from a yard out. And the Trojans have taken the early lead. gotta like that start on both sides of the football. You force the three and out, and then you score on your first drive.
Well, I know someone who doesn't like that start.
Well, yeah, the other side.
Yeah, they don't like that at all, right? This is not the way it's supposed to be. But what you just described, that's team football. Right? When you get a three and out, you're supposed to take advantage of it. You put the side of the ball. You said, thank you very much for getting us to rock. Let's put it in the end zone, and they did exactly that.
So now following the USC touchdown, on is the kick team to send this one away. Taken in the end zone, and it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt a return.
At their own 25.
The Tiger offense ready to get after it one more time. And a three and out on that first drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nail should be settled now. The first series, everybody goes out a little extra emotion. So now they'll get a chance to go back out and say, okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play and play as best we can.
You almost get a mulligan then on that first drive?
Sometimes it absolutely serves that way. You get a second opportunity. Nothing big happened. But then again, you didn't commit any mistakes either. Off you go.
And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Now this one is tight end on the right side. And a 42-yard line here and brought down there.
Elton Walker. It's a pickup of 6.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. On the carry, it's Jewel. And tackled down after a gain of 3. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down. That's some good tackling there to keep him short of that yellow line.
Yeah, and defensively, all I'm thinking is that on that play, get me to third down. Get me into a position where I can make one more play.
One
get
guy
my defense off the field.
Damn. He's got the first down before being taken down at the 46.
This drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went 3 and out.
First and 10 now for Clemson. Going to hand to Jewel. They'll get only a couple down to the 44.
Jewel, the ball carrier.
Well, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
From the 44, Cooper. And this is Simpson with a catch. That will go as a pickup of 7 on the 7th play of the drive. Play number 7 coming on this drive. It's 3rd and inches. Operating from the gun. Cooper. He's going to get his man out of the backfield. Complete. By the skin of their teeth, they are able to convert on 3rd and inches.
6 yard line.
Yeah, man, you can do that.
They'll run on first down. Jewel, and he won't get much. Maybe a couple. Down inside the 35 and the 34.
He's tackled at the 34-yard line. A gain of 2. Brings up 2nd and 8.
Throwing on 2nd and 8.
Pick. What a pick. What a pick.
Picked off at the 21.
That was a really nice interception. I think it illustrates the differences between playing man and playing zone. When you're a man, all you're focused on is the receiver in front of you. But when you're in zone, you're allowed to read the quarterback's eyes.
Damn,
that's
the back of
that's exactly what happened on that.
And now nothing but green. And with his speed, if he just finds the slightest crease, he can take it the distance like he did there.
How about the leverage up front? Offensive line out leveraging the defensive front to create that space, that crease that he was looking for. And once he hits open field, he's going to be very difficult to catch and corral.
An extra point splits the uprights. And now make the score 14-0. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone.
Damn.
And returns this to the 22.
Takes over first and 10.
And the Tiger off.
offense ready to get after it one more time. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything, at least 3 points, get that zero off the board. They follow up the gain of two with a gain of one that time.
Brings up third and seven.
Now Cooper to throw on third down.
What a pick.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off around the 37.
Time, baby.
Just saw, that's a great example of a team that was really amped up. They've been playing so well, yet they didn't get overexcited and have a bust on defense and gave up a big play. Instead, they created their own big play with a pick six. This one may be over.
Yeah, it's just the first half, but that lead has swelled to the point where you're wondering if it is over already. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Fielded in the end zone. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25.
25-yard line.
The Tiger offense ready to get after it one more time. And some dangerous territory. You're already down three scores. A three and out here, or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Again, what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and nine. And this offense on third down today, they've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third and nine. Going deep this time for Miller.
Oh, I tried to grab it.
Ground and brings up fourth down.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
A good return there, 17 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The Trojan offense ready to get their next drive started. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality?
Oh, that's a bad throw.
Hopefully there's some determination that sets in, because they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of that length, that's just not being prepared. So now, are they determined? Are they ready to read their keys and make the proper plays?
And we'll see how determined they are. Now a pass dumped off to his running back. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. Came up a little short on the last pass play. They did get 9 yards out of it, leaving him with his third and one. Short yardage situation. Here's Charles. Across midfield inside the 45.
That's a long game.
16 yards there. And that'll give him a first down. USC gets set here, first and 10. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Steps away to his left.
Damn.
And he'll go down outside of the pocket for a sack. Oh, trying to get away, but could not.
Well, maybe that can give him a little bit of a pick-me-up.
Well, they weren't playing. I say Tom Brady. They need Tom Brady.
Other than that, it's really been a first half to forget. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. 12 yards there and a first down. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33.
That's a 33-yard line.
Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. He's got a man complete. It's Clay. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. 22 yards on the catch and run. A first down.
Oh. I love Tom.
They'll throw now on the final play. And he will score. Touchdown, Sam Cowell. And the Trojans add on to their lead.
But my education continues in this game, I've got to tell you, because there's not an analyst in the world that would have said pass up the field goal here, go for it, and expect for it to be successful, and it was. I mean, they're playing this one just like a video game.
Especially for the final play of the first half to have the guts to do that. But I guess what do we say? The end will justify the means, right?
No doubt about it. For you and me, we live, we learn.
The winner goes on, the loser goes home as we start the second half of this semifinal matchup. This will make it into the end zone.
Oh, I'm a baby.
And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line.
First and 10.
The Damn SC offense here. About set to take over here. And Charles, look, I mean, coming into this one, you and I, we didn't know what to expect. This could have certainly been a disaster, nothing short of it. But this young man under center, he has certainly risen to the occasion.
He certainly has, and we certainly prepared in case it was the disaster that maybe it could have been. But there's no question, he's been the star of the show. But while we say that, let's make sure we remember the rest of the team, the supporting guys, because otherwise, we'll have a lot of mamas upset.
Damn, I thought he mentioned them,
and they have played awfully well in addition.
Back of the end zone, could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Washington now out of the gun.
His man
and he
so
takes
sorry.
It across midfield to the 45. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
45-yard line. It's a gain of six. Makes it third and four.
On play action, they'll throw. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains.
First and 10 at the 28-yard line.
They'll look to throw here on first down. That's complete. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down for a nice little game. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. They go back to the ground now with Charles. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal. The Trojans come up now first and goal. They run it. It's Charles.
Oh.
And that'll move him a little closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4-yard line.
The 4-yard line.
A second and goal from inside the 5.
And goal.
And he will score. Touchdown, Southern Cal. Is running away with this one.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury, and it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run. He finds himself open for an easy touchdown.
And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead.
35. Tigers nothing.
So now following the USC touchdown, on is the kick team to send this one away.
85-3.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
At their own 19.
The Tiger offense ready to get after it one more time. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working, and call more of that.
Side of the swing pass, and they'll get him down here at the 23. A 1-yard gain there following the 3-yard pickup on first down.
Brings up third and 6.
Cooper on third down. And he's going to be brought down here in the backfield.
It's been a tough one all game long for this offensive line. They're already down big. And now you know they're just going to come after the quarterback in a big way, don't you?
Yeah, they just can't get out of their own way right now. It's created an avalanche, and an avalanche, it's coming right on top of them. Fielded at about the 28.
Oh, take it back, take it.
Great blocking on the return. It springs him for 25. And this offense, they're going to have excellent field position. They take over with a first and 10 on the short side of the field.
On first, here's Washington.
Picks
up about six as he gets this down to the 41.
Ball carrier.
Well, Brandon, I don't think they're making any secret of what they want to do right now. They want to control the clock, keep the ball away from the other team. You just wonder, did they start to shut it down a little bit too early? I think what they're counting on, though, if they continue to move the ball and get significant gains, their energy will stay high, and they won't go into hiding too quickly.
7-yard line. That's a gain of three. It's third and one.
They'll keep it on the ground with Charles again.
And
he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. Got what he needed for the first down with a gain of two. Three quarters in the books. Back now here on EA Sports. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair.
Oh, he's down.
There he goes, right side.
Oh, he's down.
Great effort there. The second touchdown of the afternoon. As his guys continue to put this one out of reach.
Okay, we need to double check here with Marvin because he keeps all of our good stats. But what I've got is five drives, five touchdowns, and they've got a nice healthy lead.
After the first drive, we thought things might be clicking. They're really clicking at this point. They're clicking about as much as they can click.
And right,
I just
now,
said click a lot.
I'm going to shoot the quarterback.
That's okay because the guy who's coordinating the defense, trying to slow them down,
good luck.
He's going to have hair that looks like mine very soon. Not much of it.
Clemson now with a first and 10. From the gun, Cooper.
Oh!
And he finds a man with a crossing route. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first.
First and 10.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Operating from the gun.
Could have moved.
That is incomplete.
Intended for number 24.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Down before he gets into enemy territory. 12 yards there and a first down. So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. 3 yards the gain there, second down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
And he lost the football. And the defense will get their hands on it, going the other way. So they recover their own fumble. Now they face third and short.
Good move.
Following the fumble recovery, Cooper.
That's a sack, big homie.
That right now, that's a defeated team out there. I think you can see it totally in their body language.
Hands on hips, heads low. It's just been a struggle from the start.
Yeah, this team has been thoroughly beaten right from the word go.
And the punt over the side in the air, and the spot will be inside the 35.
34-yard line.
The Trojan offense ready to get their next drive started. They've got a chance now to put this game away following that last defensive stop and punt. Pretty good results here on the first down run as he takes this forward for about six. They'll come up on a second and four now from the 40-yard line.
Second and four.
They'll keep it on the ground, this time with Charles. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line.
He's brought down.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew there'd be in situations where the extra defenders in the box coming after them and trying to keep them from locking down the game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
On first down.
Damn. Washington takes to midfield, but no further. Just a yard there. Ball carrier.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run.
Oh.
Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today.
A two-yard loss on the play. It's third and 11.
On third down, he'll drop to throw.
Oh, he's
coming. The screen, it's complete.
Russell.
And he is going to lose yardage here.
To number 23.
He lost a big chunk, 6 yards there, and it leads to fourth down. Now on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. And that one hits a little too close to the goal line, and it continues into the end zone for a touchback.
20-yard line.
The Tiger offense ready to get after it one more time. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. First play of the drive going for 14 and a first down.
34-yard line.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10.
Oh.
Now they set up the screen. That's complete. 7 yards there on the first down screen play.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
McKinnon here. It's complete. And they work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. 19 yards there on the catch and run. First and 10 now for Clemson. From the gun, Cooper.
What a play.
And he's going to be intercepted a third time.
What a play.
Picked off at the 35. He's at the 30.
Don't worry about 10. It. I ain't worried about it.
And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
So on the strength of two touchdown passes, courtesy their junior quarterback.
They've only do two touchdowns.
You all right?
I'll be fine.
I was you last week. I know exactly what you're going through.
You didn't have to sit through this championship game, though.
No, but I did sit out our first state title game. That wasn't easy to do.
For all I know, this could be my only shot at it.
Then I guess we'll just have to do this all over again next season, huh?
Good luck out there tonight.
Thanks.
Who rained on your parade, Little Miss Sunshine?
I am not in the mood for this right now.
It's because you're not playing, I take it.
Like I haven't had a bad enough day already? Now I have to deal with you?
I know you're upset, but that dude Tommy's your brother. And brothers should always have each other's backs. And wipe that sourpuss look off your face. It's game time.
Here we go.
We crown a champion tonight here at Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara for the College Football Playoff National Championship game, as we'll see the Florida Gators taking on the USC Trojans.
okay, son?
Yeah, coach, I just...
Tommy. You all right, Tommy? Shit. We need some help over here. Hurry!
You got my back, right?
Of course. Always.
Then go out there and finish this thing.
Oh, hell yeah.
One shot. That's all any of us ever really gets. Wait a minute. Whole life, I want you to be an head coach. And here I am. This is your one shot to go out there and show the world who you are. You're the guy who's going to lead this team to victory. Or are you going to be remembered as the guy who got caught up in the moment and let it all slip away? I know you're worried about Tommy. Sure, we all are. But this is your one moment. Now get after it, son. Get some.
The pressure perhaps getting to this young Trojan quarterback. They trail at the break. Back now in this national championship game and what has been a tough defensive battle. And as we get ready for the second half kickoff, worth noting that Tommy Matthews does not appear to have exited the locker room with his team. We'll keep you updated as we receive. It's Charles.
Oh, he's gone.
And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he will score. Touchdown, USC.
Oh, he's gone. No safety.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. Going deep for Walker. This is caught at the 20. And he will score. Touchdown, USC. Well, since he's coming.
Oh, it's good. Also, it's a college game.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And Walker with it over the middle. And they work this well upfield across the 45. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup. Here's first and 10 for the Trojans. They run with Washington.
Oh, this is
true. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. He's already fumbled once in this game, and I thought the ball started to jostle there a little bit, but they got to him quickly at the line of scrimmage.
They sure did, and remember, if you're not a very confident runner and you've already dropped it once, if there's traffic around you, the only thing you think about is protecting the football, not gaining yards.
And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action.
With the score.
Back now here on EA Sports. Gators. As we're about ready to rock and roll for the fourth and final quarter.
Oh!
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Trying to get it to Clay that time, but it'll be second down. They work again from the 38 on second and 10.
Okay.
Now an inside handoff for Charles.
Good one.
He'll be brought down just outside of the 30. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three.
That's a gain of seven. Brings up third and three.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. That is caught at the seven. And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the seven. Well, they were in search of a short gain on third down, and they wind up nabbing over 20 yards. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw no different.
I'm running.
And he will have a touchdown. It's their quarterback. His second touchdown of the night.
Let me see. If that safety come up.
Now a play fake here on first down. Looking deep in the direction of Cooper. This is caught inside the 15. And he will score. Touchdown, USC. Charles Irvin and his slow receivers. They'll try to eat some clock now with Charles. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Nice way to start the drive. A gain of 12 and a first down.
That gives him 98 yards in this game, and he's got to feel pretty good about that, but the entire offense does. The big thing, though, Brandon, they've got to get to 100, though.
You think he knows he's at 98?
I think someone has told him by now. And here's the thing. Getting to 100 or more is tangible evidence that you've had a nice day running the football, and that's what his offensive line wants for him and for themselves.
And not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. A play-action fake. They'll look to throw. He's going to look deep here. Oh, man, it's caught inside the 10. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. The Trojans come up now first and goal. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. From the two now, second and goal. Trying to pound it in with Washington. And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. Taking it.
Oh, we got it.
Now it looks like he'll throw here. That's complete to Ward. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout as they get it with under a minute to go now in the football game. On first down, he'll drop to throw. That's going to be caught. And he will score. Touchdown, Southern Cal. So that'll do it. The USC Trojans are once again national champions. Celebration time on that sideline. It took a change at quarterback. His thoughts will turn to the condition of Tommy Matthews. But for now, jubilation as they are the national champions.
Certainly was a setback. But the bond that these two kids have is really strong. And although only one of the heartbreak kids was out there in the second half, Tommy's spirit was with him, and I believe.
You hear from Mr. Matthews?
The hoodie gave it away.
He's stable. But we're only allowing family to go back right now.
That's great, because he's my brother.
This season.
I think there's only one individual on everybody's mind tonight. This one's for my brother, Tommy Matthews.
You think that's something? You should see it in person.
Oh, man. That's so cool. Thanks so much for coming and bringing this.
You kidding me? I wouldn't miss this for anything. Coach and the guys sent their best. They waited as long as they could, but no one knew when you might wake up, so they had to catch their flights back. I told Coach I wasn't about to split up the heartbreak kids, so I stayed behind, made sure you're all right.
Thanks, man. I'm just glad you're here.
But hey, they did leave you the trophy. Wanted to make sure you had it when you woke up. How you feeling, buddy?
Like a sack of crap.
Well, that's funny, because that's exactly what I was going to say you look like.
Hey, man. Promise me one thing.
Anything.
That you'll come back next year and make him win the championship. Together.
Next year? Let's just focus on getting you healthy. One day at a time, right?
Yeah. Doc said I shouldn't overdo it.
She say what caused all this?
Yeah. Something about the stress from my filthy roommate leaving his dishes lying around the apartment. She said if it weren't for that, I'd be the pinnacle of health.
Please.
Hey, seriously. You gotta start cleaning up after yourself. It's ridiculous.
Really? Right now? Is that him? He's an hour early. Coach.
Don't look too disappointed.
No, no. I was just expecting Tommy. Come in. Care for a cupcake?
No, thanks.
So, you here for the party?
No. Give me a minute.
Okay, Coach.
Actually, I'm here to talk to you. About next season.
Yeah, sure. Talk away.
There was something you said at the start of the season earlier. It really stuck with me. It's
something good, I hope?
Well, it was something you said about treat your men like your beloved sons and they'll follow you into the deepest valley. And that really got me. And it got me thinking about the way I treat you boys and I wasn't being fair to you and Tommy, for that matter, or the team.
Wow, Coach, I really appreciate that.
All that being said, I wanted to go into the offseason with everyone on the same page. I figured the best way that we could do that would be to announce a starter. And, Tommy's gonna be our starter.
But how could you possibly make that decision after the title game? Is Tommy even going to be able to play?
Yeah, I spoke with his doctor. Valve replacement surgery was great. He's going to be right as rain.
I just don't understand.
I know this is hard for you. It's hard for you to process, and I hope you believe me when I say that I take no joy in making this decision. But I stand firmly behind it because, frankly, Tommy's a better fit for the offense.
Well, what does this mean for me?
Well, it means that you are at a monumental crossroads in your life, and you've got two choices. You can enter the draft, and based on what you did last year, I'd say you'd be lucky to get picked in the third round. But realistically, you're looking at a late-round selection, if at all.
Jeez, don't sugarcoat it for me.
Well, I'm trying to be open and honest with you. From this moment forward, I'm giving it to you as I would my own beloved son.
My other choice?
Well, the way I see it, you got too much raw athleticism to waste sitting on the bench. Your talent is a true gift. And it's one that I'm going to give you the opportunity to show it to the world.
And how's that?
You get to pick a new position on offense and get your heartbreak kids thing going back again.
Heartbreak kids. I appreciate the faith, Coach, but if I'm going to play QB at the next level, it seems like leaving now is my only shot.
That's probably true.
Wow. I did not expect all this to come to a head so soon.
Well, anything you need, just call. And when those NFL coaches come calling, trust that I'll have your back.
I'm not sure what's more strange, that interaction or the general cleanliness of this apartment.
Cupcake!
Yeah, I'm definitely finna get drafted. Fuck that.
So, the NFL Combine. I spent so much time preparing for it. Some things you can't ever say you're fully ready for. That's how the week felt to me. I walked away from the press conference feeling a buzz. Said a lot of things. Will my performance back it up?
No. This cannot be happening. Okay. Oh, man. Okay. Think. Where was the last place you looked at him?
If you knew where you last saw him, they wouldn't be lost now, would they?
Yeah, thanks. But I hope you are. You're rich.
Say it with me now. Eisen.
Right, Eisen. You're rich Eisen. Big fan. I'm gonna be the laughing stock of your next broadcast, aren't I?
Depends. You gonna run the 40 barefoot? I may have a little fun with you, but don't worry. I won't make you a running joke, huh? Come on. I thought it was pretty good.
Maybe not your best, but I'll tell you what. You let me wear your cleats, I'll laugh at any joke you have. I'm serious, I'm desperate.
Try them on? See if they fit. What's the verdict?
Perfect fit, but honestly, I don't mean to sound ungrateful, but they're a little damp. They're like really damp. Did you go swimming in these?
Thought you said you were a fan. If you were, then you'd know I just ran my annual Run Rich Run 40 for charity.
Ah, right. How'd it go?
Let's just say my days of keeping up with Saquon Barkley are behind me. Maybe you'll fare better than I did out there.
What was your time?
5.98, baby.
Well, I can't do any worse. I've seen statues move faster than that.
All right, well, I want you to go out there and post a time of at least 4.6. Think you could swing that?
With as much adrenaline as I have coursing through my veins right now from trying to find my cleats, there's no way I don't beat the combine record. I'll tell you what, I'll be even faster. Just watch.
Now that is what I like to hear. You're going to be helping those kids in St. Jude more than you know. Go get them, champ. Hope those shoes bring you good luck and an even better 40 time.
Thanks again, man.
I'm going to be slow as hell.
I feel it.
Why did I even pick that?
Welcome to another exciting edition of the NFL Scouting Combine. I'm Rich Eisen, and I'll be your tour guide as we meet the next crop of elite NFL talent. We're going to start things off with my personal favorite, the event that can break the spirit of any man, the 40-yard dash. First up, we've got one half of America's darlings, the Heartbreak Kids, an intriguing draft prospect to say the least.
Thank you.
We'll see him up next for the skills portion of this year's NFL Scouting Combine.
Got it. Got it. Okay. Okay.
Let's go now. 60 red. 60 red. Set, go.
Yeah.
Ready? Good catch. Right.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Ready.
Okay.
Got that. Here we go, set. Blue step, ready, go.
Okay.
Here we go. There we go. Set, ready. Okay.
Set, punch. Ooh. Okay.
Yeah. On the ready. Well done. Ready, go.
Yes. Up in there. Oh, you didn't get feet in there.
Ready, go.
You gotta get your feet up in there. That's the hard one right here. That's when you gotta lob that bitch up in there. Got it.
Well, today had a little bit of it all. Select few guys who may have just cemented their place as one of the top picks in the upcoming NFL draft. Until next time, I'm Rich Eisen. Welcome to the 2020 NFL Draft. Sure, the experts have done 2.7 million mock drafts, but you can toss those babies out the window. Welcome back to the first round of the 2020 NFL Draft.
Hey, this is the offensive coordinator of the Chicago Bears.
Oh, right, my God.
Oh, everything's great, Coach.
Well, look, son, we've been following you for quite some time, and we believe you could be an integral part of this team.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. I can't tell you how much this means to me. And I'm ready to do whatever it takes to show you I'm worth your pick.
I know you will. I'll expect you to show up ready, okay?
I'll be the first one there. Can't wait.
And I'm just getting confirmation that the pick is in.
Let's
take it to the podium to see who the next pick in the draft is going to be. What a phenomenal pick. This kid has shown some elite abilities on the field. He's a freak athlete. Totally capable of taking over a game in the right system.
Get out my way, little. Oh, man. Get out my way, little. She gon' put it on me, that's a lot of it. Four coupes, four seasons, drop the top of it. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of. Damn.
I got both my girls, head to toe, designer.
Drill. Let me fill myself a little bit.
Little bit, you ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. I can't hear the hate, got a lot of it. Take these bands to the bank, let them rot in it. So much ice on me, I wish I had.
Oh, yeah, I like this.
I got homies that can sleep without two. I got homies that can sleep without.
This is the player card. Here you can see your strengths and weaknesses by looking at your archetype rating. This is your development trait, superstar and superstar.
I like this.
Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit, you ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. She gon' put it on me, that's a lot of it. Four coupes, four seasons, drop the top of it. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of. I got both my girls head to toe, designer. Drill, little bit, let me feel myself a little bit.
Little bit,
you ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. West LA, that where you find me, though.
Deep. This rookie class is very deep, and perhaps no one is more hyped from this class than Tommy Matthews' old partner in crime, who was just selected in the top 10. My level of excitement for the start of the season is perhaps only rivaled by my excitement to see just what that kid's capable of doing on an NFL field. There hasn't been this kind of hype and intrigue since Tesla's Cybertruck release. So the big question I have for this year is, will this rookie sensation succumb to the hype, or will he rise to the top? Guess we'll find out soon enough after the week one games get underway. Let me
explain. Being such a high draft pick comes at a cost. Mainly, everyone expecting you to resurrect the franchise. What helped you adjust to NFL life?
I must have carried my playbook with me everywhere. If I ever wanted to prove myself as a leader on this team, I had to know everyone's responsibilities.
Okay. Jimmy Graham. Oh man, I forgot. What the flick was?
Steps towards success in this league, but don't fall back and get lazy. There's more steps ahead, so you gotta keep it up.
It is not easy being a rookie. And the excitement, the pressure, the fanfare, the interviews, the draft process. Plus, there's a lot of players banking on you to make them successful, too.
I'm a leader. What are you talking about?
Still early days, but my teammates and I were getting to know each other and building the bonds that would keep us strong and competitive throughout the upcoming season.
All right, you guys, this looks like the end of the stream for right now. Might be getting on a little later, because once I figure out how to change, let me see. Yeah.